Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Collegiate Carols. It really is wonderful to share this very special occasion with you in our absolutely magnificent school. We were a little bit worried this afternoon when it clouded over and we heard stories of westering, hard rain, etc., but God has been gracious to us and we have a beautiful evening. The girls of the college have been rehearsing for months, and tonight we are going to hear their angelic voices, and they are angels too. Just some house rules. Please do switch off your cell phones, have them on flight mode or silent so that you don't, ringing doesn't interrupt the service. If you require comfort break at any stage, it is that way. Gents upstairs and ladies down in the corner, you will find the cloakrooms. You may applaud after the carols that the girls sing. The conductor will indicate, give you a cue as to when to stand, and you may sing along with those hymns. Please enjoy the performance tonight, and may it fill you with joy and peace.
Angel. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 110th Collegiate Carols performance. Would you bow your heads with me as we open in prayer? Heavenly Father, as we gather tonight to join voices in song, we thank you for the privilege of being able to be part of this performance or associated with this wonderful school. Thank you for this opportunity to come together and by so doing, reach out to those less fortunate than ourselves. Help us tonight to reflect also on your blessings in our lives and on your incredible love for each one of us. With today being Remembrance Day, help us in particular to remember and honor those who paid the ultimate sacrifice in the pursuit of peace and reconciliation. Help us to remember and acknowledge those who have made so many sacrifices in order for us to have the opportunities afforded to us. And most importantly, help us to remember the true reason why we gather this evening, to celebrate the birth of your Son. It is with wonder and awe that we begin to consider your gift to each one of us and contemplate the depth of your love for us. It is so easy at this time of year to allow the excitement of Christmas celebrations, holidays, and expected presents to blind us to the marvel of the gift of Jesus Christ. We pray that by your grace, you will help us to be still tonight, to reflect on Jesus' offer of life in abundance, and to examine our own hearts at this special time of the year. Thank you for each collegiate girl and staff member who have worked tirelessly in preparation for this evening. Guide them, watch over them, and may their voices and words bring honor to you. We pray this in your mighty name. Amen. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you, as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Thank you.
in the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
Share the love of family and friends, and share with the things that
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Shut up.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those to whom his favor rests."
Yeah.
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you may now dismiss your servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all nations, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel." The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thought of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." Would you bow your heads with me as we pray? Heavenly Father, we stand in wonder and amazement at how great you are. We marvel at your majesty and splendor, and at how you hold the world in the palm of your hands. And yet, you have chosen to love us, to send your Son to be one of us. You long to be part of our lives and to offer us the life which we were created to live. Help us during this festive season to truly remember why we celebrate Christmas, to stop and listen for your voice, to be still and ponder your calling on our lives, and to reflect on where our hearts are at. Give us the strength and courage not to allow the world to block you out, and to daily live our lives in a way that honors you and puts you first. Help us to be men and women who stand for what is right in your eyes, despite what the world and popular opinion may say, and to be people of integrity in all that we do. Help us to listen to each other, respect each other, and to seek to understand before being understood. May we always remember that wherever life may take us, you have promised to be with us, and may we continue to hold on to your truth that when we place our lives in your hands, you have assured us that your plans for our lives are perfect in your eyes, and that you have called us to trust you with all that we are. Our world is in desperate need of your touch, Lord, now more so than ever. So may we be your hands and feet as we choose to live our lives focused on you. Thank you for each person who has participated in this amazing carol's performance. May each one of us leave having caught a glimpse of you, having had our hearts touched in a way that only you can, and may we depart determined to live out your love. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.